लास्ट टाइम वी सॉ द फ्लो नेट कंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर कन्फाइंड कंडीशंस, दैट इज इन दिस केस द बाउंड्री इक्विपोटेंशियल लाइन्स एंड द बाउंड्री फ्लो लाइन्स आर क्लियरली डिफाइंड. सो इफ दीज आर द बाउंड्री इक्विपोटेंशियल लाइन्स एंड फ्लो लाइन्स आर डिफाइंड, सो वी कैन ईजिली कंस्ट्रक्ट द फ्लो नेट इन बिटवीन दैम. And so here, as we saw, that surface AB, if the water level here is somewhere here and downstream it is here, so on this surface the total head is constant. So this surface AB is an equipotential line. And similarly surface BC, here also the total head is constant. So this surface is also an equipotential line. And this surface BD of sheet pile, so the flow cannot cross this line, so the flow will be along the sheet pile. So this BD is a flow line because flow will be along this line. And similarly this impervious bed, so flow cannot cross this impervious bed also, so flow will be along this bed. So this is also a flow line. So using these four lines AB, BC, BD and EF, so we have got two equipotential lines and two flow lines. And so these four lines define our domain and we can construct the flow net afterwards. But in case of unconfined flow, all these four conditions are not available so easily. So three of them are available, we will see. And one is not easily available. So for example, we are going to consider an earth dam. So it demonstrates the unconfined flow. So here it is an earth dam and upstream water level here is at up to level height of H, and downstream there is a filter, so water does not rise in this filter and it goes through this filter. And so it is made of homogeneous isotropic material. So using these assumptions, now again we are looking for the four conditions if we want to construct the flow net using graphical method. So two equipotential lines and two flow lines. So let's first define the datum of this flow problem. So this bed of this filter is considered as datum. So this surface here is the datum. Now take this surface AC. So any point on this surface, the total head is constant because total head is the sum of pressure head and the datum head. So if I take this point, so datum head is this part and the pressure head is from top to up to this point, so total head is equal to H. So on all the points on this surface the total head is remaining as H. So this surface AC is an equipotential line. Now come on the downstream side, here this bed of the filter, the total head here is zero because water level is not rising, but the total head is again constant. So this filter bed is again an equipotential line. Now it is assumed that the bed surface of this earth dam is impervious, so obviously the flow cannot cross this surface, so flow will always be along the surface. So the bed of earth dam is a flow line. Now we have got three conditions, two equipotential lines and one flow line. So we are missing the top flow line here. We want the top flow line. So it is clear that if the water level is up to here, so this top flow line will start somewhere here and it will end up somewhere on the filter bed on a point on the filter bed. So from various studies, so study done by Kozny and its application done by Casagrande. So he proposed that this top flow line is of the shape of a parabola. So it will start somewhere here, and the actual parabola should end at this point D, but because there has to be some modification, because we know the flow cannot start at this point D, a flow will start at the point of contact between water and this top surface, so that is C. So there is a reverse curve in this parabola between this small part. Apart from that, it is a simple parabola. So it is for the condition when there is a filter bed on the downstream side of the earth slam. If the filter bed is not there, then the condition will change. So we are taking the case when the filter bed is there on the downstream side. So now we know that this top flow line is of the shape of a parabola. So now we have to find out the equation of this parabola, or how can we locate the points on this parabola, that we have to find out. So the definition of parabola says that it is a locus of a point whose distance from a fixed point and a fixed line is equal. So to show here, if it is a parabola, so that fixed point is the focus of the parabola and fixed line is the directrix, and this is the focus, and so this distance between any point on the parabola, so this distance between the line and the point and the focus, so this distance is equal. So this is how the parabola is defined. So we can use this property to locate various points on the parabola. So first of all, we have to make the directrix. So we know there is this one more assumption, that this CD distance is equal to 0.3 times BC. So if there is a perpendicular drop from this surface A on the water surface B, from the point A to this water surface B, so this distance is BC, and this end point of the parabola on the water surface is 0.3 times BC. So from this 0.3 BC, we got the location of D. Now we can use the property of parabola to locate our directrix. So putting this distance FG, FD, take FD as radius and D as center. So taking D as center and FD as radius, cut this top surface of the top water surface at some point E. So if we take this arc, and so from here it will come like this, so where it cuts the top water surface, and from there a line is made, that is EH. So EH here is the directrix. So now we have got the directrix, and so directrix also, and this point, the starting of the filter, is the focus. F is the focus. So we have got the focus and directrix, and the midpoint will be this point on the parabola. So other points also we can find out on this parabola, such as like say some distance, at some distance x and y, x horizontal distance and y vertical distance, there is some point. So from the definition of parabola, we can find out the coordinates, such as x square plus y square is equal to x plus s. So this is x square plus y square is the distance from focus, and that is the distance of a point to point, and this is the distance of point from line. So here let's see once again. So x plus s is the distance from the line, and under root of x square plus y square will give us this distance. So this is from the property of parabola, we got this. And now if x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0 is the location of the focus. So at x is equal to 0, y is equal to s. This is one condition. And one more point we can locate similarly. To find out the s, so we know this distance of d from the focus, that is small d here. So similarly, using this equation, under root of x is replaced by d now, and d square plus, and y will be equal to h. So when x is equal to d, y is equal to h. Let's see on the diagram. So when x is equal to d, this distance when from here it is equal to d, the y coordinate becomes equal to the water surface height, water surface elevation. So that is y is equal to h. So from this equation, d square plus under root of d square plus h square is equal to d plus s. So we know d and we know h. So from here, s can be found out, d square plus h square minus d. So similarly, other points can be located now. And there is this reverse curve is plotted such that the angle between this top surface, this upstream surface of the dam and this flow line is 90 degrees. So this is how all this parabola can be plotted. And now we want to calculate the seepage through this dam, seepage calculation. So for that, again from the parabola equation, x square plus y square is equal to x plus s. Now take the square of the both sides, x square plus y square is equal to x square plus s square plus 2x s, x will cancel out, and y is equal to under root of s square plus 2x s, and dy by dx is equal to 1 upon 2 under root of s square plus 2x s times 2s. So from here, dy by dx comes out to be s upon under root of s square plus 2x s, and at x is equal to 0, dy by dx will be 1. So we know the from Darcy's law, we know that q is equal to k I a. So k will be given, that is for homogeneous and isotropic material. I here is taken as dy by dx. So that is again an assumption that the hydraulic gradient is taken as the slope of top surface. So how this assumption is valid? We know that this hydraulic gradient is equal to del h by del x, that is the head drop against the length of flow. So length should be considered in this direction. If we want to find out the proper distance, so length should be this inclined length. But we are assuming that this length we are taking as the horizontal length. So it is valid for small values of slope. So if small slope is there, then this assumption is okay. We can take that. And so from here, I we found out, and A is equal to, so when dy at x is equal to 0, A will become equal to vertical distance times unit distance in the perpendicular direction. So y into 1, but at x is equal to 0, y is equal to s. So A becomes equal to s. So the discharge from the earth dam can be given as k into dy by dx. So at x is equal to 0, dy by dx is equal to 1 times s. So q is equal to ks. So we have to find out the value of s as we saw this calculation. So using this calculations, well, not this one, this calculation, we have to find out the value of s, and from that we can calculate the discharge. And if the flow net is complete, and if we have plotted the flow net, so we can find out the discharge as K H N F upon N D. That is the universal formula. So one more thing to notice is that this top surface is in the contact of atmosphere. So in this case, the flow is coming like this. So this top surface is at atmospheric pressure, and so it is called as a phreatic line. So if it is at atmospheric pressure, it means that pressure head is equal to zero, and so the total head is equal to the elevation head. So this point helps in constructing the flow net, because when the total head is just the elevation head, so for the equipotential drops, this vertical distance between two head drops, this will be equal. If this is delta H, and so this vertical distance again is the delta H. So this is how this thing is used. And what we saw here was for the when there is some filter on the downstream side. So the water comes like this and falls into this filter. But if there is no filter, so this surface will come like this and will meet the downstream surface, and from here it will follow the downstream surface. It will not go out of this line. So if you are asked in an objective that if the line is drawn like this, so it is wrong. This top flow line can never cross this downstream surface. After this, it reaches the downstream surface, it will follow this profile and it will not cross this line, because the purpose of the dam is not served. If this flow line is crossing, that means the flow is coming out from here, and it is not possible in case of dam. That is not why we are constructing this dam. So that's it for this one, and we'll see the K permeability value for the anisotropic soil in the next one.